Set the hawk. They don't usually come from that way back in.
They come on that side,
yeah.
I'd like to figure out where they're going back there. They're going between us. I haven't been back to that farm trail in probably 3 years.
That's what I was going to
spot this morning, too.
Should go sit it.
We'll see how my leg goes the time I get to the shack.
Is up. So this morning, what you guys see here in the first part of the clip there, I seen 4 or 5 total deer, 2 does. It was too late. They were too much of the thick stuff. The deer you see in the arrow pointed at, that was a after a look through the scope, it was a yearling doe. And then behind it, I thought was another mature doe, ended up being a spike with definitely over 3 inch on one side. So obviously a no-go there by all means, but we're headed back out there right now to try to fill a last buck tag. If I don't by the end of the night, I'm just going to use that buck tag as a doe tag. So we're allowed to do that here in our zone here in Michigan, so that's the plan for this evening. Pretty good chance of making it happen. We always see deer for the most part. My dad actually this morning said he didn't see a single deer. We ended up sitting up in the front where we do take a lot of deer out of, but this evening he didn't even see any. So weather's been up and down here in Michigan. If you're from Michigan, you know exactly what I'm talking about. It's been one day 50-60 degrees and then down in the 30s 20s in the morning. It's been crazy, up and down. It's messed up our waterfowl season. Deer season's been real wonky, and using weird words now. Another thing I wanted to touch on real quick is I just went with the Sitka Fanatic system, which is the bibs and the jacket. I am telling you, I've been big into hunting especially deer hunting, since I was a kid, almost 36 years old now. And this, I've had a lot of other brands, good brands, including Scentlock. I believe it was a Scentlock Revenant then, when I wore Scentlock before Sitka. This Fanatic, as I'm telling you, is unreal. If you don't leave it unzipped on your walkout or just don't wear your jacket, if you do, you're going to sweat your ass off. It is, that stuff is super warm. It's got the wind protection on it. The body mapping system on it is amazing. The pockets are everywhere they need to be. The front, as you could tell in the beginning of the video, it zips across your body so that you have the front, the muff spot to put your hands, and you can put hand warmers in there or whatever, but you don't even need the hand warmers, I'm telling you. This jacket, this whole system is just unreal. So if you're in the market, you know, just especially over the summer, you know, save your money up. I'm telling you, get it. Whether you're against Sitka or not, which I don't know why anybody ever would be outside of, yes, it does cost a lot of money. But again, as you can tell, we do a lot of hunting, and Sitka is kept me dry, warm. It keeps you in the game longer, I'm telling you. It's well worth it. I know there's a lot of other camos out there that do as well. I could speak on Sitka because I own it. Wore Scentlock. Scentlock's also great for deer hunting. Like I said, I had the Revenant then. That stuff was warm, but I'm telling you, this Fanatic system is unmatched. For real, for real. So if you want to see a review, more of a video on it, just give me a comment down below. Let me know you want me to do it, and we'll get a little more, and I'll show you all the pockets. I know Chris B, I believe his name is. You'll see it on YouTube. You'll see his video he does, or the little thing about Fanatic. It shows it, but I can get into more depth if you need to. I'm not sure if there's any other ones out there, but if you need it, shoot me a comment down below. We'll make it happen.